Pancreas cancer patients are really some of the most difficult cancer patients to care for. They understand that they do not have a very good chance at beating this disease. So trying to give them hope, keep them motivated to tolerate the treatment that we're putting them through and realize that this is their only chance at not succumbing to the disease is important to us. We usually start with chemotherapy and we treat until your tumor markers have normalized and the PET scan shows no avidity in the tumor.
If you think of all the known cancers, it is the most deadly, the least survivable of all cancers that we know of. And that's what makes it such an awful disease to deal with. My father, died of this disease. He was diagnosed when I was in college, seemingly had a localized tumor, underwent surgery at a local center. And I remember when the surgeon came out, he said they got most of it. And I never understood that. Like, what do you mean most of that? And then soon after, we saw spread of the cancer to his liver, to his abdomen. And ultimately, he died in my arms of an aspiration event. And this is something that unfortunately continues to happen on a daily basis in the United States and globally. And so that's probably my inner drive, is that I don't want this to happen to anyone else. One of the big problems with pancreas cancer is that it's typically a late diagnosis. Once patients have signs or symptoms that lead them to the diagnosis, the majority of those patients, it's already spread. Even in patients who we don't see it spread, if we follow them long term, we eventually see things show up, meaning it's already there, it's just too small to see with current technology. If we can identify a patient with pancreas cancer at a much earlier stage, those patients are much more likely to have a curative procedure for long-term cure.
Solving those problems that really matter to our patients and to our colleagues is what drives me. It is the responsibility of people like me to be able to advance our specialty such that we can detect and identify disease at a stage where it is beyond the capabilities of human perception. And that's really the holy grail of medicine, because right now we are detecting disease at a stage where the cure is highly morbid. What AI is really good at is quantifying those very subtle changes that happen on the images that human beings cannot pick up due to the inherent limitations of their eyesight. And what we want AI to do is to help experts overcome those limitations so that we can have the best combination of machine and expert.
AI programming can identify a tumor in the pancreas with much higher resolution than the human eye. And so when we took a patient, let's say they had a tumor in the tail of the pancreas and they had a CT scan a year ago and there was nothing visible to the radiologist, but the computer can see individual pixels within that CT scan. We started looking at patients who were seen here with pancreas cancer who had a previous scan within, 1 to 2 or 3 years prior to their diagnosis, to see if we could leverage AI technology to identify that lesion prior to being aware of it.
If you were to ask me right now to sit down on a state-of-the-art computer and try to segment the pancreas, it would take me anywhere from 20 to 30 minutes and I might still not be accurate. In contrast, the AI models that we have trained can do that amount of job in a fraction of a second. And not only that, it can do that for thousands of CT scans without requiring any kind of manual input. So that's really the scale and the automation that we have been hoping to achieve for a long time. What we have seen is that AI can help us diagnose pancreas cancer almost a year before its clinical presentation.
With the future of AI and being able to see and diagnose pancreas cancers before standard imaging would identify them, that would be one of the most effective ways to treat this disease better.
Your cancer is very treatable. We still have lots of options. If we run out of options, then we get the tissue paper and we have bad conversations. We're not doing that right now. This new AI technology in detecting cancer prior to patients developing symptoms, it's not even just specific for pancreas cancer. This can be applied to a variety of other cancers. And therefore, typically, instead of waiting until a patient develops symptoms, we can identify patients who are potentially at higher risk, those that have risk factors, and therefore screen them earlier on so that we can then intervene at a much earlier date. And we can take survivals that are currently measured in months to only a couple years to hopefully many years and hopefully decades and ultimately a cure.
there is definitely hope on the horizon. We just have to make the right kind of effort and use the cutting-edge technologies like AI to be able to make that dent in this disease.